Hello everyone, Marine here for Landfun, back with a new Winter Wonderland project featuring a white castle, a wizard and two cute dragons. I started with the castle and I used the Build a Castle die set to cut all the elements. As the theme of my card suggests, I wanted to create a winter castle, so I cut the biggest pieces out of white shimmer cardstock. And for the accessories and smallest ones, I used light blue, light grey and also a touch of purple. So I assembled all the pieces just like a puzzle. Once my castle was complete, I set it aside and moved on to the coloring. I stamped images for the front panel, images to create a lovely and cozy scene, and images for the inside of the card to create the winter wonderland I had in mind. I color everything using my alcohol markers and I tried to use the few shades only, with blue, purple and grey in order to get a whole consistent look, both on the front and inside of the card. And those colors are perfect for a winter theme. Thank you. Next, I cut some elements to build the inside of my card. I used the shutter card die set to cut those pieces, but I ended up using the main panel only. To create the sky, I placed the castle die on my panel to see where I wanted it to go, and I taped the hillside stencil at the bottom of my panel. I secured everything with tape and used one of my favorite winter color combo, tumble glass, shaded lilac, and wilted violet. I first applied tumble glass from the top towards the stencil, and I moved the stencil to the right in order to color the entire panel. Next, I used shaded lilac and wilted violet to bring more contrast and magic to the sky. Once I was happy with the blending, I took the hillside stencil again, taped it on top of the sky section, and I created a hill border using tumble glass with a tiny bit of blueprint sketch. So I added a second hill border, just a little bit lower, using the same stencil and the same inks. Next step was to add a lot of details to that background, and I think that now you know the routine. Water drops first, all over the panel. Next, to bring contrast, I used the same inks as before, mixed those inks with water, and used a thin brush to create plenty of tiny drops on my background. And last but not least, a winter wonderland always needs sparkles, so I used some liquid stardust to create a super sparkly background. I set the panel aside to dry and moved on to the front panel. I cut a large stitch 4-bar rectangle out of a dark blue pattern paper, and I started by cutting a window out of this panel using the smallest die from Stitch Dance. Off screen, I colored a piece of cardstock using the same inks as before and attached my panel on top using foam squares. I attached my window panel to a second dark blue rectangle, and then I added the floor and the baseboard at the bottom of my front panel. And next I moved on to the fun part, which is sticking all the cute images to finally see the scene kind of come to life. And you know that I love to make busy cards and to create stories with my stamps, so using the shutter card die helped me to do it, because a large panel means that I can stamp and color a whole bunch of images. Once everything was attached, I applied double-sided tape on the outside of my large panel. On the right flap, I removed a backing paper and attached a piece of thread. I secured that thread with a small piece of the same double-sided tape. And I stuck a piece of the same dark blue pattern paper as before. I trimmed the excess of that paper. And off-screen, I glued another piece of thread on the front panel, right between the two dark blue panels. And finally, I attached my front panel on the left flap to totally complete my project. Finally, I used a white gel pen to make the images pop, and I tied a bow to close the card. And when you open it, you enter a magical winter wonderland where you can meet a princess and her prince, tiny fairies, a wizard and his dragons. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you very soon. Bye!